welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to look at back titration calculations. Back titrations are a specific type of titration which is often used to find the quantity of a substance that has low solubility. This means that the substance itself cannot be titrated directly with acid or alkali. First of all, the substance is reacted with a known excess of a standard solution. You then titrate the mixture or aliquots of it to find the excess moles that were added. Since you know how many moles were added at the start and you now know the excess moles, you can then calculate the number of moles that reacted with the substance. Then working backwards, using the mole ratio, you can find the moles of the substance that were there originally. And from this, you can find mass, percentage mass as required. So in this first example, we have 1.32 grams of impure magnesium that was reacted with 100 mL of 0.75 mole per litre hydrochloric acid. We know that this will be a known excess of hydrochloric acid. The resulting mixture then required 50 millilitres of 0.25 mole per litre sodium hydroxide for neutralisation. This sodium hydroxide is reacting with the excess hydrochloric acid that was added at the start. What is the percentage by mass of the magnesium in the sample? The first part that we will calculate is the moles of sodium hydroxide at the end of the reaction here. So we're going to do concentration times volume. So we have a concentration of 0.25 moles and a volume of 0.05 litres. Always remember to turn your volumes into litres. This means that we required 0.0125 moles of sodium hydroxide to react with the excess moles of hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide react in a 1-to-1 ratio. This means that if we have 0.0125 moles of sodium hydroxide, there must have been 0.0125 moles of excess hydrochloric acid. The next step is to calculate how many moles of hydrochloric acid we added at the start, again using concentration times volume. The hydrochloric acid had a concentration of 0.75 and we added 0.1 litres. So at the start of the reaction, there were 0.75 moles of hydrochloric acid available to react. Some of this reacted with the magnesium and 0.0125 moles was left over. So to find the amount which reacted, you take the moles at the start minus the moles that are left over at the end. And this gives you the number of moles that reacted as 0.0625. Using the balanced equation, we can see that 2 moles of hydrochloric acid reacts with 1 mole of magnesium. Therefore, we have 0.0625 moles of hydrochloric acid. So there would be 0.03125 moles of magnesium. To find the mass of magnesium, we take the number of moles and multiply by the gram formula mass. To get a mass of 0.759. Our final step is to find the percentage mass. So there's 0.759 grams of magnesium in the sample. The sample weighed 0.132 grams overall, and then we multiply by 100. So there was 57.5% magnesium in the sample. A common use of back titration is to investigate aspirin. Aspirin is not soluble in water, so must be reacted with sodium hydroxide rather than titrated directly. Here, 5 aspirin tablets were crushed and added 25 mL of 1 molar sodium hydroxide. The resulting mixture was then transferred to a 250 mL standard flask and made up to the mark with deionized water. This means that more aliquots can be taken. 25ml samples of the solution were titrated using 0.05 molar sulfuric acid, and the average titer for these was 8.65 mils. We're to calculate the mass of aspirin that was present in one tablet. So first of all, we're going to find the moles of sulfuric acid that were used, using concentration times volume. So the concentration is 0.05 and the volume is 0.0865. This gives a number of moles of sulfuric acid at 0.000 4325. We then need to find the number of moles of sodium hydroxide in the 25ml sample. Using the balanced equation, we can see that 1 mole of sulfuric acid will react with 2 moles of sodium hydroxide. This means that the number of moles of sodium hydroxide will be 2 times that of the number of moles of sulfuric acid. This is the number of moles in the 25ml sample. We then need to multiply by 10 to find the number of moles in the 250ml flask. Going back to the beginning of the calculation, we can calculate the number of moles of sodium hydroxide that was initially added. The concentration was 1 mole and the volume is 0.025. To find the number of moles of sodium hydroxide which reacted with the aspirin, we take the number of moles that were added at the start minus the excess in the flask at the end. Using the balanced equation again, we can see that for every 2 moles of sodium hydroxide, there is 1 mole of aspirin. So the number of moles of aspirin in 5 tablets, that which was added at the start, is half the number of moles of sodium hydroxide which reacted. We want to eventually find the mass of aspirin in one tablet, so we need to divide this value by 5. To find the mass of aspirin, we need to take the number of moles of aspirin in one tablet and multiply by the gram formula mass. So the number of moles in aspirin in one tablet is 0.001635. The gram formula mass of aspirin is 180, which can be calculated from the formula in the balanced equation. This gives a mass of aspirin in one tablet of 0.294 grams. Pause the video now and try this example. I've left you the hints for the names of the steps that you want to follow. In this example, we have a sample containing ammonium chloride, which has reacted with 100 mL of 1 molar sodium hydroxide. The excess sodium hydroxide is then reacted with 50 mL of 0.25 molar sulfuric acid. We're to try and find the mass of ammonium chloride in the sample. So the first thing we need to do is to calculate the moles of titrant that we've used at the end of the reaction. So here we're going to use moles equals concentration times volume for sulfuric acid. So the concentration is 0.25 and the volume is 0.05. This gives a number of moles of sulfuric acid as 0.0125. From the balanced equation, we can see that 1 mole of sulfuric acid reacts with 2 moles of sodium hydroxide. This means that there would have been 0.025 moles of sodium hydroxide excess at the end. The number of moles of sodium hydroxide that were added at the start is concentration of 1 multiplied by a volume of 0.1. to work out the number of moles of sodium hydroxide which reacted with the ammonium chloride, we take the number of moles which was added at the start minus the number of moles that was present at the end to get 0.075 moles reacting with the ammonium chloride. 1 mole of sodium hydroxide reacts with 1 mole of ammonium chloride. This means that there were 0.075 moles of ammonium chloride present in the substance. To find the mass of ammonium chloride, we take the number of moles and multiply by the gram formula mass. Giving a mass of ammonium chloride of 4.01 grams. Pause the video now and try this example. There are no hint steps here, but remember to work from the end of the question towards the start. There are a number of steps, and for these calculations you would get around 4 marks, so try to make sure you answer part of this even if you find them difficult. In this example, we have 0.524 grams of seashells, which contain calcium carbonate. These are reacted with 20 mL of 1 molar hydrochloric acid, and then this solution is then made up to 250 mL in a standard flask. We are assuming that the hydrochloric acid only reacts with the calcium carbonate in the seashells. 20 mL aliquots were then reacted with 0.05 mol per litre sodium hydroxide, and the average titer was 18.6 millilitres. We're trying to calculate the percentage by mass of calcium carbonate present in the seashells. So step one is always to look at your titration and calculate the moles that come from that. So we have concentration times volume. So we have a concentration of sodium hydroxide of 0.05 and a volume of 0.0186. This gives a number of moles of sodium hydroxide as 0.0093. From the balanced equation, you can see that it's a 1-to-1 ratio between sodium hydroxide and the hydrochloric acid. So within 20 mL of the sample, there will be the same number of moles of hydrochloric acid present. To be able to get to 250 mL, which is the whole flask, we need to multiply by 12.5. This gives a value of 0.011625 moles of hydrochloric acid excess in the flask. The next step is to calculate how many moles of hydrochloric acid were added at the beginning. The concentration of hydrochloric acid was 1 molar and the volume added was 0.02 litres. To work out how many moles reacted with the calcium carbonate in the seashells, we take the number of moles of hydrochloric acid that were used minus the number of moles of hydrochloric acid that were left at the end. This gives us a value of 0.008375. From the balanced equation, we can see that for every 2 moles of hydrochloric acid, there's only 1 mole of calcium carbonate. So we're going to divide this number by 2 to find how many moles of calcium carbonate were present. To work out the mass of calcium carbonate, we need to multiply by the gram formula mass. And then the final step is to calculate the percentage by mass. So we take the mass of calcium carbonate present and divide by the mass of the seashells which were used, then times by 100 to give a percentage mass of calcium carbonate in the seashells of 79.9. Thank you for watching my video. I hope that you found it helpful. Please remember to subscribe and follow me on Twitter @MissAdamsChem for regular updates on new videos and Instagram Miss Adams Chemistry for flashcards throughout the year. Bye for now.